Worth it. Hallelujah. You must know you're worth it. And he must know you're worth it. Hallelujah. He must value you. You must be. Listen. Anyhow. That's another session. Don't confuse sex with love. Don't confuse money with love. That's another thing, because he gave me money. He must love me. You're not the only one he gained money. Glory to God. He gained the prostitute money too. Hallelujah. Anybody who wants, because he loves himself. Whatever he wants, he pays for it. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Make sure you are not his prostitute. Make sure you are not his prostitute. He's paying you. Don't confuse money with love. When you are looking for a friend, when you are looking for a relationship, look for someone who loves you. Someone who honors you. Someone who respects you. Someone who will wait for you. Someone who looks at you and values you. What else do you look for in a friend? Look for transparency. Transparency. Look for someone who's not afraid to be himself or herself. Look for someone who is real. If you are hanging around persons who are not real, you're going to have a problem. Because they're going to be one thing with you, and when they are not around you, they are something else. They're going to be nice with you when you're nice to them. And when you're not so nice to them, then you see the monster come out. Glory to God. Don't build relationship. Don't have in your mind that I want to have a friendship, a long-lasting friendship with this person who is a fraud. Someone who is a fake. They're not honest. They're not true. You know, when we started the ministry many years ago, 1994, we had a young lady who used to be a part of the church. And I'm going to speak openly. And she was a part of the ministry and we're doing great together and stuff like that. Until the Lord spoke to me and the Lord said to me, I gave you the vision and I want you to be the main voice that the people listen to. And when I shared that with the church, she got upset. And you will not believe the things that she said. I mean, amazing. And everybody's like, Pastor, you surprised? So you didn't know that's how she was? I ain't know. I ain't looking. I know. I always choose to see the good in people until they show me the bad. But apparently, she was not being real. Are you understanding that? So all along, I'm thinking, yeah, we have this good relationship. When in truth and in fact, it was when the Lord spoke, and I had to do what the Lord said to do, I realized that was not a friend. Tell a neighbor, look for people who would be themselves. And let me go on the sign. One day, and I want this to minister to you. I don't just want you to hear a story, something that happened to Apostle. One day, the husband came after she left the church and all of that and had all kinds of things to say. The husband came, and I think I can't remember which pastor he spoke to, whoever he spoke to. He said, all you think, all you know she? I live with she. Who she is in church is not who she is at home. I'm going somewhere with this. You see, one of the reasons we're finding out why children who grow up in church from the time they reach 18, 19, but some of them even before that, no, they didn't want to come to church. Do you know why? Ask me why. Because you, the parent, you have two lives, one at church and one at home. And the one at home is not a nice one. And the children know mommy is a hypocrite. Daddy is a hypocrite. He has been church preaching and prophesying and laying hands on people. And then when he go home, he coughing mommy in the eye. He cussing everybody. Bad word. That is not how Christians are supposed to live. He don't treat the children home right. He just is a mean man. He's not a Christian. And you know what? Because parents are supposed to model life. Not just life, God, before their children. Yeah? You are the first God your children will know. Hallelujah. The God you present to them, when you behave like that, you know what it communicates to them? I don't want to serve this God. So the first opportunity they get to leave church, they're gone. Because they don't want that kind of God. You've got to be real. Tell your neighbor, you've got to be real. Hallelujah. Look for people who are real. What you see is what you get. Hallelujah. Transparency. Transparency. Look for loyalty in others. Loyalty. Say with me, loyalty. Glory to God. And loyalty is always about whether someone will stay with you or they will go. At the bottom, that's the bottom line of loyalty. Amen? Would you stay with me or would you leave me? I would never leave you either. Listen. Loyalty, you have to look for loyalty in people. You've got to look for people who have been through some things. Oh, my God. Hallelujah. And stuck with it. Hallelujah. If someone comes into your life and say, you know what? You're my only friend. Run. Run. They don't have no friends. Run. They went to elementary school, then they went to secondary school, and they had no friend. Run! They grew up in a village with other people. Especially in Tobago, we are very family-oriented. We about neighbors. We about people. We're warm and that kind of, and you don't have no friend. Run! Forest, run! Listen, it's very important for you to understand that. Look for persons who have been through some stuff, who stuck with some things. Hallelujah. People who the first sign of trouble, they run. What they are saying to you is that they are not loyal. What they are saying is that if trouble comes to you, they will run and leave you too. I had to deal with a situation a few years ago where in our circle, we had a situation and the position that some took. I mean, I could not for the life of me understand how you could take a position like that. When we say we have a covenant relationship, people, listen to me, tell your neighbor, don't talk with two sides of your mouth, man. Say what you mean and mean what you say. It's time for us to be real. Real Christian. Real people. Hallelujah. Real followers of Jesus. And when they took the position, I had to say, I call a meeting with every one of them. And I said, wait now. So, that is what I have to look forward to? Would you leave me too? That's what Jesus asked his disciples. Jesus preached a message, and people were leaving Jesus' ministry. Why? Because they were in the church for what they wanted. They were following Jesus with their own agenda in mind. People could be following you, but it's not about you, it's about them. And when they started to leave Jesus, Jesus turned around, he looked at the 12, and he said, are you going to leave too, or are you going to stay? He called them to a place of loyalty. And that's one of the things that church folks don't understand. We need to get to understand what it means to be loyal. To be loyal means that no matter what happens, I am with you. To be loyal means, listen, as we say in Tobago, if you're sucking salt, we suck in salt together. Hallelujah. To be loyal means sink or float, as staying on the boat. That's what it means to be loyal. Whether you're sick, I'm going to be with you. Some people only like you when you're well and everything working. And the moment something ain't working, they don't want to associate with you. Some people only want to be with you when you're quote unquote perfect. The moment you make a mistake, the moment you do something wrong, they abandon you as if you're going to stay in them. And some people, it's not even when you do something wrong, it's when you do something they don't like. You marry someone they don't like, and they cut you off. But you know you have to live with the person you ball. Hallelujah. You just need to me. You have to support. You have to be there for your friends. Hallelujah. Listen to me. When you stay with people, people will stay with you. It is a height of hypocrisy. We've got people not loyal to anybody, but they expect people to be loyal to them. Wait your turn coming. I say, wait your turn coming. One of the things we do at our church is that we ensure that persons who join our churches understand that our church is not a breakaway church. We didn't start a church because I get vexed with some pastor and I leave and I go and start my own church. No. Because that is disloyalty. When you start anything, listen to me, when you start anything in that from a place of disloyalty, you are sowing a seed that will bring a harvest one day. Hallelujah. Churches that start with church splits always split. Tell your neighbor loyalty. Look for people, connect with people, listen to me, who will stay with you for the long haul. Tell your neighbor, we are in this for the long haul. Hallelujah. Jesus chose men who were loyal. Jesus looked for people to build friendships with who were loyal. Listen to me, watch this. Every one of his disciples died for him, except Judas. Every one of them died for him. What would make them die? All you have to say is, I don't like Jesus anymore. All you have to say is, no. You see that man? I am not associating with him anymore. They gave their lives for him. They were loyal. Tell your neighbor, they were loyal. And we need to look for loyalty in others. And we need to be loyal to our friends. We need to be loyal friends. A loyal person is someone you can trust. I said a loyal person is someone you can trust. Hallelujah. A loyal person, listen to me, is someone you can depend on. My God. Hallelujah. That's the problem, you know. Listen to me. When you're looking for friends, when you are a friend, your friend must be able to depend on you. Let's go, because I wanna be very careful of my time today. Look for a friend, yeah, who is not judgmental. Look for the ability in people, yeah, to see things, yeah, the way they are, right? And not always have to pass judgment on it. You have to look for those qualities in people. There are some people, everything they see, they judge. You're not God. You don't know everything. You don't have all the information. You don't know the hearts of people. Why this happened or why that didn't happen. So don't pass a judgment. You see them, sir? All of them. All of them are going hell. No. No. You see what they do there? No, listen to me. Listen to me. Watch that in people. Let me tell you something about people. Whatever people will do with you, they will turn around and do it to you. Why? Because it's just who they are. It's just who they are. Whenever people show you who they are, you better believe them. Believe them. Don't take bully flay to go and look for thing in the night when you see it in the day. Glory to God. Watch this. Look for persons, look for friends who won't judge you, especially when you fail. You think when I make a mistake, I want my friends to come and just pointing the finger, this, shoving it, keep reminding me of my failure, my mistake. Job had three friends. And when Job lost everything, his friends showed up. They were his friends, you know. And all these guys can do is judge Job. Job is senior sin. And many Christians are like that. Whenever we see things go wrong, we always look to say, is sin, she's sin. Now, sometimes it's sin, she's sin. But it's not for us to judge. Sometimes it's sin, he's sin. But God has a way of dealing with that. Hallelujah. You as a friend, your role is not God in that person's life. Your role is to support. Your role is to pray for. Your role is to help. Your role is to encourage. Yes, this may be going on, but God, your role is to prophesy. Your role is to lay hands on the sick and see them recover. Your role is to cast out the demon. Your role is to do whatever you have to do by the power of God to ensure that your friend stays alive. Job's friends were wrong. And many times we are wrong. Many, many times we are so wrong and we hurt others in the process. Some people, it takes them years to get healed. Because when your friend, someone you trust, someone you love, someone you went to church together with, someone you hang out with, you went movie tongue with, you eat together, you cook together, you sleep on the same bed together, or you roll over together, it ain't easy to recover from that kind of stuff. If you're going to be a good friend, learn how not to judge people. Learn how not to jump to conclusions. And look for people who are like that also. Learn how to encourage and build up and not to break down. Because you know when we judge others, what happens? An invisible wall comes up between us and them. Can't see it, but it's there. And what happened? Relational paralysis sets in. What else do we look for in people? I tapped into this before. Looked for people who you can depend on. Let me just, I want to expand this a little bit. This man, let's go back to the man in our text. He had four friends. And the Bible said that Jesus was in his hometown, Capernaum. They heard that Jesus was there, and they decided they wanted to take their friend to the meeting to get healed. Wow. These four friends were dependable friends. Hallelujah. They carried their friend. They could have gone to the meeting alone and get blessed and get prophetic word and get hand laid on and get oil and fall long and get back up. But they took their sick friend. They brought their friend to church. You see, you need people you can depend on. You need people like that. Tell your neighbor, I need people like that in my life. Because you see, most of us don't see ourselves as ever needing anybody. We always see ourselves as being whole. We always see ourselves as being well. And that's the right way to see yourself. But Solomon, one of the wisest men to have ever lived, said something. He said, you don't know when trouble gonna come. None of us don't know when calamity gonna hit the house. Hallelujah. One day we could be doing good and everything okay. Hallelujah. And it just take one storm and we're homeless. One hurricane, Flora. One fire. Listen to me. That's why we can't walk. No, I'm telling you. Because we need people. That's why it's not good for us to be alone. Because you might not feel like if you need anybody, no, but you don't know what tomorrow would bring. Hallelujah. And you might just need not just one person. You might just need everybody to rally around you. You might just need the whole village to rally around you. You're walking through Plymouth and you ain't talking to nobody. And you're Christian enough. You ain't talking to nobody. Glory to God. Tell your neighbor, no. We need to be dependable. And we need people we can depend on because we don't know what tomorrow will bring. That's why we need to be nice to people. Are you with me? Things that friends do, they look out for each other. They look out for each other. Your friends got your back. Hallelujah. Your friends cover you. Hallelujah. They cover your faults. Your friends don't expose you. Your friends don't bad talk you. Talk to me. And they don't allow anybody to bad talk you. I have a few friends. When they do good, they're good. When they do bad, they're still good. Because it's my friend. We had a situation in our church in the early years, and them days I was a bad pastor. I was bad, but I was immature. Anyhow, this young lady had a situation. It seemed to me like a recurring decimal. This year, I'm going to put a stop to it. Get pregnant one time, get pregnant two times. I said, what do you think this is? Is that a joke? So I passed a law. In the church. I said, no one is to go and visit her. Let her learn how to. If you're going to be a part of a community, then you gotta behave as if you're a part of a community. Don't want to do your own thing and then the whole community has to suffer. I said, let her learn what it means to be by herself and then maybe she would appreciate the church. So I said, no one is to go and visit her. She had a baby, you know. You don't have one already. Struggling. No one is to talk to her as the Lord, the pastor, passed. Listen to me. Nobody listened to me. They went behind my back. They carry food. They carry Pampers. They carry milk. They carry today that young lady is one of our leaders in our church. Because she had friends in the ministry. And even when I said, don't go and help her, let she learn, they went behind my back and supported their friend. Tell your neighbor that's what friends are for. No, I'm not that kind of pastor anymore. But I still expect when I give an instruction that for it to be carried out. Hallelujah. Your friends will go the extra mile for you. Hallelujah. They will do things other people will not do for you. Hallelujah. That's why we need friends and good friends. Yeah? Your friends will take off roofs for you. Your friends will carry you. Even when you're heavy, listen, when it comes weighty, they will not drop you because they value you. Hallelujah. Your friends will stick with you until you get back on your feet. Ask your neighbor, are you a good friend? Hallelujah. And this may mean give your friend money. This may mean paying some bills. This may mean, watch this, this may mean taking your friend to live with you for a while. It may mean looking after their children. Hallelujah. While they are away or whatever the situation may be. But that's what friends are for. Tell your neighbor that's what friends are for. Friends stay together in the good times and in the bad times. Hallelujah. And finally, I want to wrap up the message. Friends are people who would bring you to Jesus. They will do that for you. If you are a child of God today, and you have friends who are unsaved, one of the best things you can do for your friend is bring that friend to Jesus. Now look at this. I want to wrap this up. Jesus is in the room and he's teaching. He's at Capernaum because he didn't do much miracles there. Yeah? Suddenly the roof opens up and he sees four men with their friend, lowering the friend before him. And Jesus says, my God, look at their faith. Those of you that are here today, and you may not be Christians, you may not be followers of Christ, but you have a friend who is. You need to thank God for your friend. Hallelujah. You need to thank God for your Christian friends. Hallelujah. Listen, because this man had four friends who dared and who put aside everything for him so that he can be healed, so that he can be free. When Jesus saw their faith, he said, son, your sins are forgiven. Why did Jesus say, your sins are forgiven? The Lord spoke to me, you know. The Lord said to me, some people's healing will never come unless they receive forgiveness of their sins.
Your faith is in God. Tell him what you want. Tell him what you want. He ain't no mind reader. You know what you want.
It's a song that the Lord gave me not too long ago. It's a simple song. I want you to learn and sing along. It just says,